This is a very critical slide because we are viewing the development of the heart in a lateral view. That means we are seeing it from the side. The concentrate your attention on item A of this illustration. You can see that in this, the circle that is drawn is the pericardial cavity. I have already told you that the heart is developing, that tubular heart, whether it is one chamber, two chambers, whatever it is, it's all going on inside the pericardial cavity. Initially, the cavity is very small, and you will notice that as the heart is developing inside this pericardial cavity, it is attached to the area above it by a small flap of mesoderm. We call them and call it as the mesocardium. Now, that mesocardium has to completely disappear. Only then the heart can start looping. I repeat, the first step in the looping of the heart is the disappearance of the mesocardium. I repeat, disappearance of the mesocardium. Once that starts, that's what is shown in the item B. Small hole in the mesocardium becomes a complete hole. Whatever is black is the cavity, and whatever is shaded is not the cavity. So from A, you can see that this is the region I'm highlighting. That is a mesocardium. It is disappearing, and this black becomes completely black here, and the other black is there. That means by the time it reaches the level of the item C, the heart tube has lengthened, it has grown in size, and it is showing some shape changes. Yes, a stage has come that this heart tube can no more remain straight and end to end inside the peritoneal cavity. Too much of lengthening is taking place, so there is a struggle for space. As a result, watch carefully what is opening. The first bend or the first looping begins. Now that loop begins at the junction between the bulbous cordis and the ventricle. You see, bulbous cordis and the ventricle. Hence, this loop is called the bulboventricular loop. Am I clear? This loop is called the bulboventricular loop. The loop is so designed that the convexity of the loop is below and the concavity is above. The loop further improves. That means the two ends, you see, the two ends, namely the arterial end here and the venous end here, are brought closer. I repeat, are brought closer, so that this loop finally becomes a U-shaped structure. In other words, from a straight tube, we have now ended with a U-shaped heart tube, where the upper ends of the two U, the one in front and one behind, the one in front is the arterial end and the one behind is the venous end. Have you understood this point? Any doubts? Because the next few slides are based on what you have understood at this point of time. If there are any doubts, I would like to take a pause, give you some clarification, and then proceed.
So could you please repeat the CND part once again, please?
Which one? C and D, item C and item D. Now up to B is clear, isn't it? Up to B,
yes sir,
it's a reasonably fairly long tube. At the front end of the heart tube is the arterial end. At the back end is the venous end. That is why the sinus venosus is seen. This is the two horns of the sinus venosus. This one is the sinus venosus. Clear? Now you see the same sinus venosus, I repeat, the same sinus venosus is being pulled inwards into the peritoneal cavity. Similarly, at the other end, see, watching the diagram, see, I hope, at the other end, the arterial end is being brought backwards, the venous end is brought forwards. Got it? Therefore, in item D, you will see that the arterial and the venous end are coming closer and closer. At what cost? At what cost means at the cost of bending of the tube at the region where the bulbous cordis, this one, this is the bulbous cordis, this is the ventricle. At the junction of the bulbous cordis and the ventricle, the loop begins, the first loop, that is called the bulboventricular loop. Understood?
So,
Next, once the loop is formed, you can re-establish the locations of the bulbous cortex. This part is called the conus, and the part here behind is the ventricle. You can see the almost the whole of the atrium has got into the pericardial cavity. Not only the atrium, in item D you can see it has pulled in some amount of the sinus venosus also. Finally, you know what happens? The atrium and the sinus venosus together, that means the developing atrium and sinus venosus together, they form the final atrium. They form the final atrium. Shall I proceed further?